You want to know a surprising way to really get to know what your subject looks like? Yes? Then keep watching.
Hi, I'm Sara and I make art. This week I'm going to be demonstrating blind contour. So like I said, I talked about blind contour before and I have a card with my blind contour video up. If you're not sure what blind contour is, go watch that and then come back and watch this one.
I want you to understand, the point of doing a blind contour isn't to make a great drawing. It's to force yourself to focus intently on your subject and really get to know the lines and contours of it. Ideally, when you're doing blind contour, you would block out everything else and make what you're drawing your sole focus. The point where you don't focus on anything else, literally including how you're doing the drawing. The first time I did blind contour, I felt like I was making a great drawing, and then I look at my work and it was nothing like what I thought it was. I really wanted to include my head in this video so you can see that I'm not looking at what I'm drawing. And I even angled my reference photo away from where I was drawing, so I couldn't even see it out of the corner of my eye. And I'll tell you, when you're doing this exercise, you're going to be really tempted to look back at your drawing to see how it's coming along, but don't do it. It's cheating. I said at the beginning of this demonstration that the purpose of doing blind contour is to get the lines and contours of what you're drawing imprinted in your mind. And even a couple of days after doing this, I can picture the lines and contours of these people's faces who are my cousin Katie and her daughter Adelaya. I can actually see in my mind how their faces are shaped. I really think that's the result of taking in those things with my eyes and also drawing the shapes with my hand at the same time. And something that helps with this even more is to draw slowly. Because by drawing slowly, which is not always easy, you force yourself to think about the lines even more. If you see me pausing every once in a while, that's because I'm really thinking hard about the lines that I'm drawing. And I'm trying to mentally record them. I'm literally thinking things like, her forehead has a sharp slant going down, her shoulder is slanted and also curves going down, and her arm curve slightly outward. You know, just watching the footage of this video back while I'm recording this voiceover and looking at my face, and I had no idea I was looking at that picture so intently. I have something very serious to talk about here. Adelaya has been diagnosed with leukemia, and her parents have a fundraiser. They need donations. I'll link the fundraiser down below. If you could donate, it would really help them out, and I want to tell you thank you from them. Okay, this whole thing was a bit nerve-wracking, but when I was getting ready to draw Adelaya, it was a bit more so because I had to draw a second figure. I just had to put my pencil down in the best place I could think of, having no way of knowing that I'm not drawing my second figure right on top of my first. Today I made a sketch of these two because I'm definitely going to be doing a real painting based on this photo, and you'll see that in a coming video. But if you want to see the sketch now, it's on my Instagram and my Facebook, which are Sara Makes Art 1 and Sara Makes Art respectively. In fact, today I decided on what color I'm going to paint the background, and I realized Adelaya is the second child that I'm depicting in my artwork. The first one was that little girl that I painted for my painting Little Girl with Pink Satin. Looking at this footage, I think she almost looks angry, which is not at all what she looks like in the photo, but that's blind contour for you. I know me drawing Adelaya didn't show up very well in the video, so here's just a shot of how she came out.
I actually got the idea to do this video when I saw the YouTube singer Roomie do a video where he and his editor and friend Jonas make music without hearing it. It's a pretty funny video. I'll link it in a description. But I thought, I wish there was a visual art equivalent to that. And there was, which I just showed you. But blind contour isn't just some gimmicky thing that I'm doing for a YouTube video. It's a legitimate artistic exercise that you'll probably be asked to do if you take a drawing class. And even though I haven't practiced it much since taking that class, the combination of looking at a drawing, of looking at or an object, anything that you're drawing, and moving your hand in motions to draw it, somehow imprints it in your mind more than if you were looking at your paper as you were drawing.
If you want to know how I can draw when I actually am looking at my drawing, watch any of the videos in my drawing tips playlist. I have some on the screen now. There's a card in the upper right-hand corner that'll take you there.
I make art videos, so if that sounds good to you, make sure you click this to subscribe so I can help you bring out your creativity.